Now to Sydney, and a comedian Jerry Seinfeld fired back at an anti-Israeli protester who disrupted his show last night.
We have a genius, ladies and gentlemen. He solved the Middle East. He solved it. It's the Jewish comedians. That's who we have to get. They're the ones doing everything. Yeah, go ahead, keep going. They're going to start punching you in about 3 seconds, so I would try and get all of your genius out so we can all learn from you.
He makes a good point there. Why is his show being disrupted by these pro-Palestinian, anti-Israeli protesters? Is it just because he's Jewish? Are Jews not allowed to be pro-Israel without having their livelihoods impacted? It seems very strange to spend presumably hundreds of dollars to buy a ticket to be there and then to pull that.
Well, it shows their lack of power in this situation, that they have to use Jerry Seinfeld in order to amplify their message that they want. But the thing that I found really interesting with that clip that we've seen was the reaction from the audience. And I think what that does is sum up the way people are feeling. We're not without compassion. Anyone who's going through a war in their homeland, we certainly feel for them. But don't bring anger and don't ruin someone's night in order to make your point. I think people are getting very sick of protests and of people being persecuted and made to feel fear here in Australia, which is a peaceful country. Don't bring a war from somewhere else into our country. And that was an example of it happening at that show.
Absolutely. There was not much support for him at all. No. Now, an explosive new book into David and Victoria Beckham's marriage is about to hit the shelves, and it's casting doubts on the loved-up couple, the image they portrayed during that Netflix documentary Beckham. Tom Bauer will allege Brand Beckham is basically a business relationship as opposed to a happy marriage, with separate PR reps who wage media wars occasionally. And this all came about after David's infidelity. We've heard all about that. And they stayed together, apparently, Dee Dee, to protect the brand. Now, I know you love the doco, you've watched it.
Yep.
Do you buy this interpretation of what their marriage is?
No, I don't want to hear a word against Posh and Beck. I was just watching a nice little Instagram video he put up. He was growing some spring onions for Victoria.
You are buying the Beckham propaganda
the
completely.
Previous one, he was growing her a beautiful pink rose and she was out there with him in the garden. Look, my first thought when I saw this story was this was some sort of dispute between these two when they were living on separate continents doing their particular jobs 9 years ago. And I just thought, if this is all this Tom Bauer has got to bring up a fight that this couple had 9 years ago, he got nothing. The documentary is everything. You will not damage Brand Beckham any worse than they did themselves with that vile wedding they had, you know, with the purple and the regal.
Yeah. No, I had a memory hold that. Yeah. Dee Dee Dunleavy, thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure, Rita. Thanks for having me.